Getting ready for first pitch at Citizens Bank Park. It's the Marlins and the Phillies, and it comes your way next. Time for Baseball on the Show as we get you set for baseball at a place they call The Bank, Citizens Bank Park in Philadelphia. Tonight it's game three of this four-game set between the Miami Marlins and the Philadelphia Phillies. Hi again, folks. Matt Vasgersian here to bring you this matchup of NL Eastern Division rivals. Along with me are Eric Karros and Steve Lyons. And EK, let's take a quick look back at what's transpired over the first two games in this four-game set.
Yeah, it's been a great start to the series on the road. You see there, these guys have come in and taken the first two games of this four-game set. They're playing with a lot of confidence right now, and it's obviously showing in their results.
More from the guys as this one goes along, but first, let's have a look at the starting lineup for the visiting Miami Marlins, as their order will read like this. And there you see the starting pitcher they'll match up against as you look at his numbers on the right side of your screen. Christian Yelich makes his way to the plate now as we're just about set for baseball this evening.
Left fielder, Christian Yelich.
And the first pitch of the night here is taken for ball one, and we're officially underway in Philadelphia.
First pitch, 7-0.
Swing and a miss as he ramps up on the fastball, 1-1. Game time temperature tonight, a comfortable 66 degrees at first pitch. No contact there, and it's 1-2.
Just overmatched him there.
Line hard, but foul. And he stays alive as this is grounded foul. Another 1-2 delivery. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. And the catch is made, one away. So Burnett able to record that first out here, and with that, let's take a look at how the Phils will set up on D. It's brought to us by Majestic, the official uniform of Major League Baseball. Derek Dietrich will stand in, back in the lineup after getting the night off yesterday. Knuckle curve breaks outside for ball one. And that swung on and missed on a pitch down, 1-1.
For the infielders tonight, be prepared. If he gets that sinker working like he normally does, it should generate a lot of ground balls.
No offer on that one, two balls and a strike. fastball, and looks like they're pinching him a bit here. It's 3-1. Don't go too far. The dangerous Giancarlo Stanton gets his shot next. Full count now, 3-2.
That's right where he's going to need to be against this lineup, on the corners all night long.
And this is fouled straight back. And he lays off here, ball four, and he'll become the game's first base runner here with one away.
That's an easy take right there on the 3-2 pitch. Not all that inviting at all. You want to at least make the guy think about hacking up there. Instead, now he's on with one away.
Giancarlo Stanton will get his first shot here with the runner at first now and one away. Now about a 58-foot breaking pitch that he wisely lays off here.
Well, not really how you want to start the next guy after a walk. That pitch isn't even close.
That missed. Close. It's ball two.
Yeah, he didn't seem to do him any favors with the previous batter, and now here's another call that goes against him on the mound.
The 2-0 on the way. Now a swing and a ball popped high in the air over toward foul ground. But he's going to get there as he runs it down on the warning track for the second out of the inning.
These are the ones that are hard to swallow. Got the count in your favor. 2-0, get a fastball right down the pipe, you wind up popping it straight up. And that's a missed opportunity, folks. Big time.
Greg Dobbs will dig in, and this season certainly hasn't been all that kind to him as he enters play with the average down in the 230s. A called strike to the 35-year-old veteran. Nothing and one. Dobbs can't come up with that one as he falls into a quick hole here, 0-2.
Yeah, that pitch is still up a little bit, but at least this one was out on a corner. But I don't think I'd want to be making a living up there too much.
Still sticking with the fastball, but this time he lays off. It's 1-2.
Not too sure how you take that one on 0-2.
Yeah, not too sure how you call it a ball either.
And a sinker there, swung on and missed for out number three. Marlins leave one. So now the Phillies offense will see what they can do. No score. Starting lineup for the Phillies is there on your screen. Kevin Slowey will be on the mound to face them, and if he's going to be successful against these hitters, he's going to need to keep the ball down in the strike zone without question. And in the field, the Marlins will align themselves like this. Ben Revere will stand in now, and this is certainly a guy that can beat you in a lot of ways, currently your National League stolen base leader. Fastball in there for a called strike. And there's the full list of stolen base leaders in the National League. Line hard to center field. Bogusevic is right there, one down.
That's just some bad luck right there. With the outfield at their normal depth, this ball might have gotten down. But with them playing in, well, it's a completely different story.
Jimmy Rollins will stand in, hoping to turn things around from the loss last night. He was 0 for 4 in that ball game. And now here's a swing and a ground ball to third. And a base hit as that's into left, and they've got themselves a one-out base runner.
And that's a good sign right there. They're really hoping to get him going out of that two spot. And he comes through big time right here with a first inning single.
Marlon Byrd will dig in for the first time here, looking to change his fortunes a bit as he's seen that average dip these last four or so games. Change up here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball. Runner at first here, one man out. And they pitch out here, but nothing's going on. Here comes the 2-0. 3-0 now.
Is he worrying too much about that guy on first?
I think he might be. Guys worry so much about the stolen base, but they don't realize that a walk is 10 times worse.
Swing and a ball hit foul as this will find the seats in right. Over to first, and he'll dive back in. Check on Rollins, now the pitch. There goes Rollins, and that swung on and fouled straight back. And he lays off here. A nice job. It's ball four. First and second now with one away.
You can't fault the pitch selection or the location there. It's well placed, maybe just a hair off the outside corner. But 3-2, that's where you want to be.
Ryan Howard will stand in now. And as you can see here, he enters play fourth in the National League in round trippers. This is on the ground to short. Could be two. One there. On to Jones. Not in time. And they'll just get the one.
Boy, and this would have been a really costly double play. But fortunately, he's hustling all the way down the line. And he's able to beat that throw on the back end.
John Mayberry will stand in, getting the start here despite being out of the lineup last night. First offering on the way. There's a good fastball on the outside corner as he'll take a look at strike one. On the ground is short. And an underhanded throw is in time for out number three. Phillies leave a couple. We've played an inning. No score. Garrett Jones will stand in now, still struggling to get anything going offensively.
First baseman, Garrett Jones.
And he'll take strike one on the fastball, registering at 93 that time.
That's one of those fastballs that just never feels like it's going to be a strike. It's up at the letters, and that's a tough one to do anything with.
And he just gets a piece there as this is chopped foul. And this is going to be a foul ball. And he'll just fight this one off as it's chopped foul. And he'll fight just to stay alive here as this is fouled away. And a tough pitch on two strikes as he's able to foul it off. The 0-2 once more. And he reaches for one out of the zone and misses rather badly for the first out.
And when you know you've got a guy in protect mode up there and he's fouling off pitches left and right, that's when you know you can just keep taking him further and further away. He winds up getting the punch out here on a pitch that's well out of the zone.
Brian Bogusevic will get his first opportunity now. And he'll power in a fastball that time at 94 for strike one.
Oh, a very hittable pitch, too. That's a middle-of-the-plate fastball. And he's not going to get away with too many of those tonight.
Just off the plate and high, ball one. Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. And they'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. Yeah. Swing and a miss as he starts the frame with back-to-back strikeouts here. Three in a row going back to the last inning, and there are two away.
That's now three straight strikeouts going back to last inning. Whatever he's throwing, it's working up there.
So bases are empty here with two gone, and that'll bring in Jared Saltalamacchia. Here's the first offering. And this will be lined into center field, and they've got themselves their first hit of the ball game.
Whoa, that's what you call chuck and duck right there. This ball's going to come screaming right back at him. He doesn't have any time to get the glove up, and it gets safely on into center field.
Adani Echevarria will get his first cuts here with two gone now and a runner at first. And a ball 1-0.
Pitch count already becoming a factor. He's at 34 now. Still not out of the second inning.
Too much bite on the sinker, and he's behind 2-0 now. Very patient here in these opening few innings.
And I think that's exactly what they're going to need to do. The more hitters counts that you can get yourself in, the more fastballs you're going to see. And this is a good fastball hitting team.
That one's in there on the black, 2-1. Come set, now the pitch. Could have been 3-1. Instead, it's 2-2.
Yeah, kind of a late decision to swing there. Even if he hits that thing, that might just be a routine fly to right.
Struck him out on a good pitch there. And if you're keeping tabs, that's his 100th punch out of the season. One left for Miami. We'll go to the bottom of the second, no score. Will Nieves will start things off in the bottom of the second. First pitch to him. And he got him out in front that time. Strike one. And boy, big problems here to start this at bat. It's 0-2 now. He can't get him to bite this time. It's 1-2.
Yeah, a smart pitch there. If you got him to reach for it 0-1, maybe he'll do it again 0-2.
Tried to hold up there. Appeal down to first and no swing. It's ball two. And this is hit hard to the right side. Foul. Ready with another 2-2. And this ball is also hit foul and heading for the seats, so we'll have to do it again. Still 2-2. And he gets some pretty good wood on it here as this is lifted to fairly deep left. Yelich able to take this one in, and there's your first out.
And you know, he's kind of going through a stretch right now where the ball just isn't jumping off his bat. He's got a good pitch to hit right here. Looked like he put a good swing on it, but it just didn't go anywhere.
Kevin Franzen will stand in. Here's the first offering. Curveball, and that misses in the dirt for ball one.
Yeah, those are the ones you like to start in at bat, especially your first time up.
I agree. Give me a nice, easy one in the dirt that I can take so I can really get ahead in that count early.
And a pitch down that swung on and sent to second base. Throw on to the first baseman. Jones is in time. Two away now. Freddie Galvis will get his first chance now, trying to get something started with two away here in the bottom of the second. And that misses ball one.
Close pitch. Maybe just off the plate, but if it was, it wasn't by more than half an inch or so.
Let's go, Phillies!
Now here's the ball hit sharply toward the right side. And that is in there for a two-out base knock.
mission accomplished there with two away. You just want to give your pitcher a chance to hit here this inning instead of leading off the next one.
He does it with a solid single there.
So a runner at first here with two gone in the inning, and it'll be up to Burnett to see if he can come up with something here. Fouled straight back. Ball one. And he'll take a look at a strike on the inside corner. It's 1-2. Swing and a ground ball to first. On to first with it is Jones as he steps on the bag to retire the side. One left for Philadelphia. We'll move to the third with no score. Kevin Slowey will turn right around and get us started here. 9-1-2 to start inning number three. High and tight here to begin the inning. It's ball one. And this catches the outside corner, strike one. This one runs a little too far in, ball two.
This guy is almost no threat up at the plate. I mean, you could get away with fastballs right down the middle if you wanted to.
The catcher wanted it down, and they got him to chase it for strike two. Now the pitch. Swing and a miss as he starts the third the same way he ended the second, with a punch out, one away.
Well, always nice to get the inning started against the pitcher, and he sets him down easily for the first out of the third.
Christian Yelich will get a second shot now. He grounded out to start the ball game. Right there for strike one. And just lucky to make contact on that one as it's chopped foul. Third inning, no score to this point. That misses, says the home plate umpire. 1-2. Where it misses, I'm not quite sure.
I think that's consistent with how the strike zone gets called nowadays. You know, that's a strike in the rule book, but most umpires won't give you that pitch anymore.
Swing and a miss as he starts the frame with back-to-back strikeouts here. Three in a row going back to the last inning, and there are two away.
And after that pitch was called a ball on the pitch before, I mean, I think this actually qualifies as strike four. You know, on the mound, he's probably thinking, hey, can I apply the credit to the next guy?
Derek Dietrich will stand in here hoping to at least put a ball in play here this inning. Here's a sinker to start him out, but he wouldn't bite. It's ball one.
And even with two outs, this is a team that can still put something together here.
especially in this part of the lineup, so you can't let your guard down.
Here's a changeup that's right there, 1-1. Just got a piece of it as it's fouled back. And this one's chopped foul right at home plate. Here he comes again, 1-2. 2-2 now with two away and the base is empty. Two out, nobody on. Full count, 3-2.
And you know what that fellow waiting on deck? If you believe in protection in the batting order, this guy is going to get something to hit right here.
And this misses for ball four. The second walk he surrendered here in the first three innings.
Now batting. Right fielder,
Giancarlo Stanton will dig in now, hoping to perhaps make him pay for the two-out walk. Now here's the first pitch. I had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away. And a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball. And that misses, 2-1. In there, 2-2.
Yeah, a little surprising he didn't offer at that one. That was a dangerous spot for a good fastball hitter.
Shallow center, and he can't track it down. A base hit, and they'll stop the runner at second base, but there are two on and two out now.
All right, now batting third baseman
Greg Dobbs will stand in with two on and two out here in the third. Burnett checks. Now the pitch. First pitch is a sinker, too low, 1-0.
Well, we've mentioned it already, but look at the pitch count here in the third inning. He's almost completely out of gas already.
Now it's 2-0.
And one thing you can't do here, you cannot lose him and load the bases. He's still got a couple pitches to play with, but I'd expect this one to be somewhere in a strike zone.
No lead to speak of at second. Here's the pitch. Donnie couldn't pull that one back as he clearly broke the plane of the plate, and that'll be ruled a strike. And he's fallen behind now, 3-1.
Whoa, that one definitely took off on him right there. He's lucky that thing didn't go all the way to the backstop.
And he misses with it for ball four, so the bases will be loaded now with two away.
That's two walks now here in this third inning. I mean, it seems like he's having a hard time picking up the catcher right now.
Garrett Jones will get a chance here in one of the bigger spots in the ball game thus far. Bases loaded now with two away. Now the first pitch lays off 1-0.
And with two walks in the inning already, he can't afford to fall behind anybody else if he wants to stay in the game.
Nowhere to put him here as he falls behind now 2-0.
Well, he's starting to put himself into a no-win situation. Obviously, you don't want to walk home a run, but you can't just throw a cookie in there because he could bring in four with one swing.
Up and out over the plate, but a called strike, 2-1.
That might take the anxiety away for the moment, but he's going to need a couple more here to prove to himself that he's not losing it.
Let's get out of this inning.
And this is fouled back and out of play. Both teams with just two hits apiece thus far. Just does stay alive as this is fouled back. The 2-2 one more time. And this misses, so it'll set up a big pitch coming up. It's full 3-2.
Now, you can't think corner or perfect pitch here on the mound. And this has got to be somewhere near the middle, and you just got to hope you get lucky.
And now this is swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Revere is there as he makes the catch, and they'll tightrope out of danger as he strands the bases loaded. A couple of walks, but no damage. Back with more on our Wednesday night showcase right after this. Ben Revere makes his way to the plate to get us started here in the bottom of inning number three. Now a ball lying toward the gap in left center, but this will be pulled in out there in left center. Well hit, but a rough out number one.
First pitch swinging here to start the inning, and he didn't waste any time waiting for his pitch. He got it right there. Just hit it right at somebody.
Jimmy Rollins will dig in. He singled his first time around. First pitch curveball swung on and missed. Strike one.
Well, he's gotten away here early with leaving some of these pitches out over the middle of the plate, especially to start some of these at-bats.
That's taken. Now it's 0-2.
Yeah, he must have been looking for that same breaking ball because that pitch, it's right there.
One and two now to the former MVP.
Well, I think that fastball is just for show there. He's not trying to throw this for a strike.
Now a swing, and he just fouls this one away. Here's another 1-2. Here's a swing and a foul ball. And Rollins will lay off here, and he's worked the count back to 2-2.
Ooh, there's a tough one to take right there on a 1-2 pitch, especially after fighting off so many pitches leading up to that one.
And that's low, so a good eye there as he works the count back full.
Wow, what an at-bat he's having right now. He's fought off some tough pitches, he's laid off a few pitches like that one, and now he's worked his way back to a 3-2 count.
And he can only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an 8-pitch at-bat.
Yeah, both these two starters are matching each other in the early innings, stride for stride.
He's an out away now from a 1-2-3 bottom of the third.
So bases are empty here with two gone. And standing in now is Marlon Byrd. Here's a cold strike about thigh high, nothing and one. And he lays off for ball one.
And if he can get himself into a fastball count, don't be surprised if he has a big cut at something. Maybe try and break this tie ball game.
Here's the 1-1 pitch. Here's one that misses now to the Philly right fielder. It's two balls and a strike.
Yeah, even with the bases empty here and two away, you still need to be careful here. So he's pitched him smart so far.
Took a good cut that time, but comes up empty, 2-2. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2. Now a ball hit foul down the line in right and in amongst the fans. And a little battle brewing here as he fights off the two strike pitch and chops it foul. And he goes the other way with the fastball as this is hit in the air toward the gap in right center. And that'll get down for what should be extra bases. And he is in the second with a two-out double.
Yeah, this one was starting to look like it was going to be a 1-2-3 inning, but now all of a sudden, they have the go-ahead run standing out there at second base after the two-out double.
Man at second here with two away, and digging in, slugging first baseman Ryan Howard. Fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0. For Byrd, that's 12 doubles now on the campaign. And wow, a very high strike, but a strike nonetheless, and it's 1-1.
Well, he's been in a tough stretch offensively, and this sure ain't gonna help.
One and two now. Bottom of inning number three, nothing, nothing our score. Now a ball hit high down the left field line, but back in amongst the spectators, foul. And a sinker there, swung on and missed for out number three. Danger averted following the two-out double. The three of us return with more Wednesday Night Baseball after this. Brian Bogusevic will stand in now to get us going here in the fourth.
Brian Bogusevic.
First pitch of the inning is taken low and away for a ball. It's 1-0. and a fastball here that's taken for ball two.
After the strikeout his first time around, I think he was able to use that first at-bat as a learning experience. Those have both been real good takes.
And this ball will be chopped foul. And this one's going to bounce up to the plate. An easy take there, and it's 3-1 now.
Oh, I think you'd be real happy with a leadoff walk. Something just to get things started against this guy.
No leadoff walk just yet as that finds the strike zone and the count comes full at 3-2.
Let's go, Philly!
And he just manages to stay alive here as he fights this one foul. And he gets a piece here as this ball is fouled away. Has to fight to stay alive as this is fouled off to the right. And he swings at the fastball here and lifts it into the air to shallow center. Therefore, it is Revere. One away.
Well, that was a struggle with a capital S, but he finally gets him to lift the fly ball here to end the 9-pitch at-bat. That'll take some life out of the arm.
So one away here with the bases empty. And coming up, the switch-hitting backstop, Jared Saltalamacchia. First pitch coming. And that's in there for strike one. Out in front as he pulls this one down the line at first. But that'll get foul. It's 0-2 now. And a swing and a miss as they caught him reaching that time, and there are two away.
Well, right now he is just carving them up, dare I say, like a Thanksgiving turkey. That's 7 strikeouts already, and he's made it look easy so far.
Adani Echevarria will stride in again. He struck out swinging his first time. First pitch is a changeup for a called strike. Hit hard, but this will be a foul ball. And he'll try and tempt him with one in the dirt, but he'll hold back here. It's 1-2.
And now, as a hitter, 1-2, you've got to be thinking right center field. He'll take a little swing out and try to drive something the other way.
And it's to 2-2 now with the bases empty and two gone here in the inning.
And the hope was that he would have chased one of those pitches, but now on 2-2, I don't think you fool around anymore.
And he struck him out, his 8th punch out of the ballgame, and that one ends the inning. A.J. Burnett looking like the Burnett of old. It remains nothing-nothing. John Mayberry will lead things off here in the home half of the fourth. And this is going to be a foul ball. Now the 0-1 is swung on and hit on the ground to third. Throw over by Dobbs is in time for out number one.
Now batting, catcher, Will Nieves.
Will Nieves will dig in here. He flew out his first time around. First pitch coming. And he gets a piece of it here, but it's chopped foul. Off the plate, one ball, one strike. And this is fought off at the plate as it's chopped foul. And a breaking ball lined into left field, a base hit. Kevin Franzen will stand in. He grounded out his first time. Here's the first pitch to him. And easy to read the thought process here as he starts him out with a sinker below the knees, and it's 1-0. And he fires in a strike this time to make it one ball and one strike.
Oh, that's a good fastball right there, and you had to figure that he was looking for that sinker.
Grounded foul off to the right and over toward the dugout. Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number four. Here comes the 1-2. Tried to hold up there. Appeal down to first and no swing. It's ball two. And he lays off, so it's full now, 3-2.
Now the question, do you send the guy on 3-2 with one out? You figure you're going to get something around the plate.
Just did get a piece of that one, so he stays alive here. Full count pitch on its way. Now here's a ball sent out to right center field, and that's going to get down for him, a base hit.
And this is something they've worked on in the batting cages, taking some of the movement out of his swing. Much more compact now, and he's seeing some definite results.
Freddy Galvis will stand in, a base hit his first time around. First offering to him stays upstairs. It's a ball and no strikes.
Well, be careful not to airmail that thing over your catcher's head. You got to make sure you don't overthrow it.
No runs, five hits, and no errors on the ledger for the Phillies to this point. Downstairs, two balls and no strikes. Eric, what are you looking for here?
It's a fastball count, but he doesn't always play by the rules out there, so this could very well be a slider or something away. So, in other words, I have no idea.
And here's a ball out towards straightaway center field. Bogusevic is there now, and he has it, two gone.
Well, we're still looking for that first run of the ball game. Thought for a second this might be it, but it just didn't have enough steam behind it.
A.J. Burnett will get a shot here with two on and two out here in the fourth. And that's by him. It's 0-1. No runs, five hits, and no errors on the ledger for the Phillies to this point. That's over, but low, it's a ball and a strike. Now a ball lined to the right side. That's in there, base hit. And they'll put the brakes on that runner at third, and that means the bases are loaded now with two away.
How about that swing? That wasn't just a little bleeder off the end of his bat. He swung that bat like he knew what he was doing up there.
Ben Revere will dig in here with the bases loaded now and their best opportunity yet to get on the board.
They've had a few chances and come up empty, so they can't let this one get away from them.
And a high strike there, 0-1.
Yeah, definitely taken all the way. Not a bad idea with the bases loaded.
And this catches the zone as well. It's 0-2 now.
He's still got to make one more big pitch, but this is a great start with the bases loaded.
Too low with a fastball there. One ball, two strikes.
On 0-2, if that's a curveball, a changeup, a sinker, then maybe you get a guy to chase. But it's much easier to lay off a pitch down there when it's a straight fastball.
The right-hander deals on 1-2. Swinging a ground ball towards the middle. And, that caught him flush as it ricochets toward first. But the recovery throw will be in time to first. Good job that time of not giving up on the play, and the inning is over. Kevin Slowey will come forward now to start things out against his opposite number. And these two have matched each other pitch for pitch here through the first half or so of this ball game.
Yeah, I think we had an idea runs might be hard to come by. You know, maybe not this hard to come by, but both of these guys have been just about flawless so far.
Burnett right back at it as this is swung on and missed for the first strike.
Well, we've talked about all the strikeouts. The only side effect is right there, though. He's run up a pretty high pitch count now.
Fouled back. Sliced down the line at first. And this one gets past Howard down the line. It's a fair ball.
Boy, he's doing it all out there so far. Not only is he pitching a great game, but he gets in on the act offensively as well.
Christian Yelich will try it again. He's grounded out and struck out in two trips.
Hey, try turn to the double play for one.
Now the first pitch. And a fastball to start things out here. Not close. It's a ball and no strikes. Now a swing and a ground ball back up the middle. And that'll get by into center field for a base hit. And the runner holds at second, so they're at first and second now with nobody out.
Can't ask for a whole lot more to start the inning. Hey, back-to-back base hits have them threaten to score our first run of the night.
Derek Dietrich will stand in now with two on here and nobody out to begin the inning.
And on the mound, he hasn't found himself in too many rough spots so far, so this might be his first real test of the ballgame.
Now some movement out in the Phillies' bullpen as a lefty and a right-hander start to loosen. Burnett checks. Now the pitch. And this is hit hard up the middle. And that's through into right field for a base hit. Around third and being waved on home. And that'll drive in the run from second as they're on the board first, 1-0.
Took us a little while, but we've got our first run on the scoreboard here in the fifth. You've got to figure, any more they could add on here could really go a long way.
Giancarlo Stanton will come forward now. He has flied out and singled so far. And a fastball is in there for strike one. Is that really the spot you want to be messing with here?
Shouldn't be. That's a danger zone if you ask me.
And oh, you talk about getting a pitcher's call. There's one there and it's 0-2.
And maybe that's off the black just a little bit, but when you're around the plate as much as he's been, you're going to find that you're going to get a few calls like that.
Struck him out, and he becomes the ninth strikeout victim thus far.
And if you're looking for round numbers, that's strikeout number 100 for him now on the season. Now, that's a number that I know he would like to cut down on, but sometimes you just got to take the good with the bad.
Greg Dobbs will stand in. Base on balls his last time. Now a swing and a ground ball. This gets foul. It's 0-1. Runners lead from first and third. Here's the pitch. Good knuckle curve, and he's got him behind 0-2. And he continues to labor here, coming up on 100 pitches in just the fifth inning. Breaking ball. That's in the dirt as he takes a ball.
And even on 1-2 now, you've got to expand the strike zone a little up there. You can't go down looking here. You've got to put this ball in play.
And he lays off it to even the count 2-2. Where do you go from here?
I think he's set up for something off speed. If you can put that changeup below his knees, he won't come within a foot of it.
Fouled back. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. Rollins. Relay to Howard, and it's in time. The double play, that ends the inning. Marlins forced to settle for one. Home half of the fifth coming up. It's the Marlins 1 and the Phillies nothing. Jimmy Rollins will stand in to start things out here in the home half of the fifth. And you get the sense, Steve, that this crowd's been pretty well taken out of the ballgame to this point.
Yeah, they pretty much had to sit on their hands all afternoon. Not a lot to get excited about so far. And I think that's a credit to that man out there on the mound. He's cut right through this lineup for the first four innings.
Trying to bunt his way aboard, but this will get foul. Now a late bunt attempt here, but he misses strike two. Line hard to the left side. Foul. Swing and a liner. And reined in, one away. So still nothing against him on the scoreboard here in the fifth as we check out the league leaderboard for team ERA. And as of this moment, they're currently tied for second in that department. Marlon Byrd will dig in. He doubled his last time. Below the knees, one ball, no strikes. This pitch sails up and in, and that leaves him muttering to himself. It's ball two. Can't imagine guys like that too much.
Yeah, not too much indeed. You start getting into the danger area when it's up and in that high.
Down low, and the plot thickens here, 3-0. Ryan Howard set to follow. He waits on deck. And he finally gets a sinker over here for a called strike one. And this will be nowhere close as his control deserts him here. It's a five-pitch walk.
And you'd like to say, good job there, good eye. But in reality, nobody's swinging at that pitch. It's not even close.
Ryan Howard will stand in 0-for-2 in the ballgame so far. Runners on the move for second. Pitch is a called strike. The throw. It's right there, and he is out at second on a great throw by Saltalamacchia.
Well, he showed a lot of patience to work out the walk, but then he got a little impatient trying to steal second base. And they throw him out pretty easily there on the first pitch.
Here we go. And he goes against the shift there as this is on the ground at the left side. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Down quickly go the Phillies. They're down 1-0. Garrett Jones will stand in to lead things off as the Marlins look to get things started here in their half of the sixth.
Garrett Jones.
Now some movement out in the Phillies bullpen as a lefty and a right-hander start to loosen. And he goes against the shift there as this is on the ground at the left side. And they will get, no, he's in there, a very close play at first.
Yeah, and about the only drawback you have to having so many strikeouts is that it really runs that pitch count up. You can see on the graphic right here that that total's starting to get up there now, so he may be getting just a little bit tired.
Here comes the Philly skipper on his way out toward the mound, and it appears that'll do it for A.J. Burnett. He'll wind up lasting just five innings here. Didn't pitch all that poorly, yet he's gone nonetheless. Michael Stutes will come on in relief now as he'll make his 35th appearance of the season. Brian Bogusevic will be the first to stand in against the new pitcher as he'll do so with a runner at first and nobody out.
That one is gonna throw.
And this is off the corner and low, ball one.
Earn your paycheck to turn the dude.
And that's swung on and fouled straight back. Opposite field to left. But he'll hardly need to move out there in left as this is hauled in for the first down.
Well, this certainly is not any kind of a routine play out there. As you can see, this ball is slicing away from him, but he's still got his sights on it all the way, and he gets over there to make the play.
So a runner at first now with one away, and that'll bring in Jared Saltalamacchia. Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one.
Let's go, Philadelphia.
Quick. And boy, was he ever fooled on that pitch. It's 0-2 now.
Down 0-2 after two great sliders. He's got his work cut out for him now.
And he couldn't get him to chase the 0-2 fastball. It's 1-2.
Not a real good 0-2 there. You don't necessarily want it in the zone, but you do want to at least give him something to think about.
To two balls and two strikes now.
And when he's down 0-2, he's smart enough to know guys are going to try and get him to chase. So now at 2-2, he's got himself back to a spot where he doesn't have to go after a pitcher's pitch.
And here's a ball hit in the air. And no one can get there as it falls. And the throw will come back in quickly, so it's first and second now with only one away.
Yeah, he had a chance to put him away. Had him down 0-2, tried to get him to chase a couple of times, but he wouldn't do it. And he winds up making contact on a good pitch there.
Adani Echevarria will dig in now, hitless in his two at-bats so far. And this is fouled back and out of play. Keeping him close there at second. Now the pitch. That's taken. Now it's 0-2.
0-2, you gotta shorten up. Find some way at least to put the ball in play. You can't afford a strikeout here with an important run out there at second base.
And did he hold up in time? A look down, and yes, he went around. It's strike three.
Well, this is a stroll he's taken five times in this series now. That slow walk back to the dugout after getting punched out. After a while, these things, they start to wear on you. You've got to try to keep the mindset that every at-bat's a new opportunity, but most of the time, that's easier said than done.
Kevin Slowey. Get a shot now in an RBI spot, so a chance to help his own cause here.
And he's got a hit in the game already, so he can handle the bat at least a little bit.
All right, here's an easy strikeout.
And he'll hold off on the slider here to start the at-bat. It's ball one.
Let's go, Billy!
Slider, but that's low as it's dug out by the catcher there.
Well, you know, sometimes it's that natural tendency to let up just a little bit when you're facing the opposing pitcher. You know he's not going to do much damage, but you got to get refocused here because you do not want to go 3-0 to him.
Outside, 3-0 now.
Of all the people to lose the strike zone against in this lineup, he's got to be out there thinking, how is this happening against the pitcher?
Two down, runners at first and second. That one's in there, 3-1.
Yeah, definitely taken there. May very well take another.
That's in there, and it'll run the count to full, 3-2.
That's a borderline strike right there, and I think that he had one step out of the batter's box headed towards first already.
And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight. Back-to-back strikeouts keep him out of danger. Back with more on our Wednesday night showcase right after this. John Mayberry will stand in to lead things off here in the Philadelphia sixth. And now the Marlins bullpen will swing into action as a lefty and a right-hander start to get loose. Gets under this one as this is hit high and pretty deep out there to center field. Bogusevic is there, and these fans won't like that as it's a one pitch out to begin the home half of the sixth.
Here's a look at his pitches by inning so far. That last one was number 84, so they're getting near the point where they'll need to start keeping tabs on him.
Will Nieves will dig in, 1-for-2 to this point in the ball game. First pitch on the way. Now a fastball a bit too low here. It's ball one. And this is going to be a foul ball. One pitch is lifted in the air out to right. Under it now is Stanton to make the catch, and there are two away now.
Yeah, that's just a low fastball here on the outside corner. You see him try to drive the ball the other way, but he got under it just a little bit too much, and that becomes an easy flyout.
Kevin Franzen will dig in, 1-for-2. He grounded out the first time and followed that with a base hit in his second plate appearance. And that's high for a ball, 1-0.
You know, maybe the most impressive thing about his performance so far, he's doing it all in a hitter's ballpark. Now, it's hard to come in here and pitch like this, but he's done a heck of a job.
Now he runs up and gets this one down. There to play it is Dobbs. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. Phillies down in order. They trail this one, 1-0. Welcome back to Citizens Bank Park here in Philadelphia. It's on to the seventh inning with the Marlins on top, and it's a good time to check out our game summary through the first six innings of play. And now we're going to have a conference at the home plate area, so it would appear that we'll see a double switch here. Jake Diekman will come on now, and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. Cody Ashe is into the ball game as well, as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting ninth now on the double switch.
Number 25, Cody.
Christian Yelich will stand in here to start the seventh in a game that's been sailing along to this point. First pitch is a sinker for a called strike one. And now he drops one down here, and he'll try to beat it out. And the throw is wide as he couldn't keep his foot on the bag that time, and we'll have to see how they want to score that play.
Yeah, these are always tough. A catcher's always got that clock ticking in his head, and on a bunny, he's thinking he's got to get rid of this ball quickly. Actually, I think he had a little more time than he thought he did, and he winds up firing this ball right down the right field line.
Derek Dietrich will stand in now, and he'll likely have a look down to third to see if anything's up here with nobody out. Big hole on the right side. Here's the first pitch. Ball one. Now some movement out in the Phillies' bullpen as a lefty and a right-hander start to loosen. And he'll try to hold back the swing, but he'll do so unsuccessfully as that's ruled a strike. Good action on the sinker, one and two.
And you know, his changeup and sinker sort of do the same thing. They both drop off the table pretty good at the end. The only difference is he usually wants you to hit his sinker, and he wants you to swing and miss at the changeup.
Here comes a 1-2. And a good take there. Close, but it's 2-2.
Boy, that's a good take there. I don't think I could have laid off that one.
Nobody out, runner on first. Now the 2-2 pitch. Here's a hard hit ball back up the middle. Barehanded for one. Over to Howard, and indeed they get them both.
Well, that's how you pick up your defense right there. We let the leadoff man get on in an error. No big deal. I got this. He gets the double play ball on the next guy, and everything is forgotten. And now we start over.
Giancarlo Stanton will get another crack, 1-for-3 thus far. Up and in for ball one.
Let's go! All right, let's win!
And a fastball in there for a strike, 1-1.
That thing's coming in there hot, 96 miles an hour.
And he pumps the fastball by him here. 1-2 now. Very difficult to get on top of a pitch when it's coming in that high.
Darn near impossible when it's coming at you in the high 90s. You just can't get your hands up there fast enough to stay on top.
In tight with the slider, 2-2.
Oh, that's not a bad idea right there. Go ahead and try that back foot slider on a 1-2. Hope you can get him to commit. That's a good job of laying off of that pitch.
And he struck him out. Second time tonight now that he's been set down on strikes. Marlins down quietly, but they hold a 1-0 lead. Freddy Galvis will dig in now. A single and a flyout for him in two trips thus far. A couple of lefties start to get loose now in the bullpen. First pitch coming. And he'll look at a first pitch curveball that's in the dirt. It's ball one. And a fastball that's about off the radar screen there. It's 2-0.
And down by a run, a leadoff walk would certainly help the cause. He's got to shrink that strike zone here and not chase anything that he shouldn't be swinging at.
Three and oh now.
And it goes without saying, but this has to be in the strike zone. You don't want him on base to start off the inning.
Yeah. Now the 3-0 pitch.
Here we go.
And a good comeback there. It's 3-1.
And at the plate, he might have been told, look, you're taken until you get a strike. It's not a bad idea.
Here's a swing and a high pop-up. Drifting into foul territory now toward the third base dugout. And this is taken in for out number one.
And that's telling of how they've swung the bats. This has just been a punchless offense. And this pop-up is pretty indicative of their struggles.
Cody Ashe will come on, and as he's newly entered into the ballgame, he'll get his first plate appearance now here in inning number seven. And now the Marlins bullpen will swing into action as a lefty and a right-hander start to get loose. And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one.
Yeah, he's definitely still bringing it. It's the seventh inning, and we're still hearing the catcher's mitt snapping all the way up here.
And a check swing here, but he pretty clearly broke the plane, and it's 0-2 now. One out, nobody on. And this is swung on and sent on the ground to first. And he'll take this to the bag himself, and there are two away now.
Now batting.
Ben Revere will stand in for the fourth time now, still looking for his first hit of the ball game.
And he's not the only one either. This has been a great pitching performance so far, and they've had these guys chasing their tails all game long.
First pitch to him. That's out to left. Does he have another 1-2-3 inning? He does. Eight in a row he's set down, and the side is retired. Three up, three down for Philadelphia. It remains 1-0. Greg Dobbs will stand in to lead off the inning. Middle third of the lineup, 4, 5, and 6, as they try to get something going.
And this whole lineup's been pretty quiet all game long. Just the one run, that's it.
And he gets ahead 0-1.
Oh, and you wonder if maybe he decided beforehand just to take a pitch up there first. Too bad for him, because that thing was right down Broadway.
And a good sinker there as it's bounced to third. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number eight. Pitching certainly has been on display in this one, and there's the evidence of it right there. 1-0 our score, as there are an awful lot of zeros on that line score to this point. Garrett Jones will step in, a base hit in his last time. Inside with the fastball, it's 1-0. Bases are empty, one man out. In there, 1-1. Really a good job so far by this guy out of the bullpen.
Yeah, he's come in and really put his stamp on this game. He's thrown a lot of strikes. That's what you want.
The 1-1 now to Jones. And he gets a piece of this one to foul it toward the backstop. And this will be fouled away. Hard sinker misses, 2-2. And now a ball hit fairly well here out to the deep part of left field. And that'll get down out there for extra bases. And he is in at second base with a one-out double.
Well, this is really a laser right here. You're going to see it pretty much go right over his head out there and left, and it'll one-hop the left field wall. That's going to allow his man to cruise into second with an easy double.
Brian Bogusevic will step in now in a big spot here in a game as close as this one.
And a chance at redemption, too, because he hasn't done much through his first three plate appearances, but he could make up for all of that with a base hit right here.
Fastball, and he turns on one, sending it high and deep to right. And that is into the right field seats. It's a home run. A two-run blast to straightaway right field. Seven home runs for him on the year now, as the Marlins have taken a 3-0 lead.
Sooner or later, somebody was going to get him. That's just the first home run he's allowed out of the bullpen all season long. He's been lights out all year, but he got beat there.
New pitcher set to take over, and it's the veteran right-hander Sean Camp. Jared Saltalamacchia will be the first one to greet him as he'll start fresh here with the bases empty following the home run. He'll start him with a sinker here, but that sinks a bit too much that time. It's 1-0. That slider truly in an unhittable spot. It's 1-1. Sinker is right there for a called strike two. Oh, and they pulled a string on a good changeup there as he swings and misses, and he's set down on strikes for the second time tonight.
And that changeup's not really a pitch you can sit on with two strikes, because if he gives you that fastball, you'll be an hour late on it. That's a great job of not showing that pitch until he was ready to punch him out.
Adani Echevarria will have another go. He struck out looking his last time. Here's the first offering. And a hard sinker there, chopped foul at home plate. Swing and a miss, and he's in trouble now, 0-2.
And after three strikeouts already, you can bet he's going to be pressing up there at the plate, trying to make something happen. And that just might make things worse.
And he struck him out again. So that's the old sombrero there, partner. Four strikeouts in the ballgame. But two in the inning for the Marlins thanks to the two-run home run. Bottom of the eighth coming up. It's 3-0 Miami. Jimmy Rollins will lead things off here in the bottom half of inning number eight. Watches a fastball right there for strike one. And now the second pitch of the inning will be his 100th of the ballgame. And a sinker sinks too much there as it bounces into the catcher's glove. And now the Marlins bullpen will swing into action as a lefty and a right-hander start to get loose. And a sinker dips too low there. Into the dirt, in fact.
You got to think one thing here. Get on base. A walk will do the trick.
Called strike two.
Another good pitch there. I'm not sure he's throwing a bad slider tonight. Every one of them has had a ton of movement.
And he lays off the curveball. Strike three called, and that's going to be out number one.
Yeah, he just keeps rolling right along. He's shut out intact. Just get a look at his line so far. Through seven and a third innings now, they've just not been able to mount any type of offense against him at all.
Marlon Byrd will stand in, base on balls his last time. Here's one hit towards the hole, and that is through into right field for a one-out single.
Back into the stretch for him again as we take a look at his line so far. It's almost like he's kept that shutout going with smoke and mirrors because he's definitely given up his share of base runners. They just haven't amounted to anything so far.
Ryan Howard will stand in, and they've been able to hold him in check so far, 0 for 3 to this point.
Yeah, it's kind of surprising that he's been a non-factor in this one, usually a major force in their offense.
That hits the outside corner. It's strike one. A look here at the hits per side here in the late going. Now a chopper to first. Might only get one. Echevarria for one. On to first, but not in time as he's in there ahead of the throw.
Well, this is a much easier play for a left-handed first baseman to make, especially when you're charging in like that. He doesn't have to turn his back to the plate, so he gets a good gauge on whether he still has time or not, and he's able to fire onto second base in time to get that force out.
John Mayberry will try again, 0 for 3 thus far. High strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1. I know we have a tendency in the media to get hung up on pitch counts, but this is a legitimate workload he's sweated through so far.
Yeah, anytime you get up around that 110 mark, you put in a full shift, and he's fast approaching it here.
Now a slider is swung on and grounded toward short. And eight innings have come and gone now as the inning is over. Phillies strand one. They trail it here 3-0. Reed Johnson will try to get his club a little ninth inning insurance as he'll grab a bat to pinch hit, leading things off here. Ninth inning underway now as the first pitch is taken for a called strike.
And he's probably not going to throw too many first pitch changeups. That's a pretty darn good call.
That's in there as well. It's a quick 0-2 count.
And I know it's your first at-bat of the ball game and you want to work the count a little, but those were two pretty good pitches to have a rip at.
Swing and a miss, and he's got that strikeout pitch working now. That's three in a row for him as there's one away.
Hard to do much better than this. I mean, here are the only three batters he's faced since coming on. Strikeout, strikeout, and strikeout. Boy, that is flat dealing there.
Christian Yelich will step in, one for four in the ballgame. And that's dead center for strike one. And he misses with it, one and one. And he just gets a piece there as this is chopped foul. One out, nobody on. Tough pitch to lay off there, but he did, and it's even up at 2-2. Swing and a hard ground ball to third. Oh, and he has some trouble with it.
Second baseman.
Now the skipper's on his way out toward the home plate area, and I believe that means we're going to have a double switch here. Antonio Bastardo will take over now with one away in the top of inning number nine.
Number 59, Antonio Bastardo, now playing left field and batting the seventh spot. Number nine, Dominic Brown.
Derek Dietrich will get another shot. He hit into a double play his last time. First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one.
That run is gonna go.
Up around the letters with that one for ball two.
Well, you've got the matchup you wanted, but that's not going to amount to much if he can't throw strikes.
Runners on first with one down. Ball three. Don't go too far. The dangerous Giancarlo Stanton gets his shot next. And there's a strike as he'll try to work his way back. It's 3-1.
Not often you'll see a 3-0 slider, but when you need a strike, any pitch will do.
And that is in there at the letters to run it full, 3-2.
Might not be a bad time to have a look over to first. Make sure they don't have any ideas of trying to send him to keep out of the double play.
Swing and a miss, and they come back from a 3-0 count to sit him down on strikes, and there are two gone.
Well, that's all about playing the percentages there. They bring the left-hander out of the bullpen to get the better matchup, and he obliges with the big strikeout.
So it's a runner at first with two men out and set to stand in the ultra-dangerous Giancarlo Stanton. They set the target in, and this finds the inside corner for strike one.
And you can see him trying to be a little bit more patient here. He's got two strikeouts already, but he's got to be careful not to fall too far behind.
One good fastball deserves another as he jumps ahead 0-2 now.
And he's really going to have to fight now. You got to take a little bit out of your swing and find a way to put this ball in play.
He can't get him to bite this time. It's 1-2.
Tough pitch to lay off there with two strikes. I'm not sure if that was a good take or whether he just got fooled on a changeup and couldn't pull the trigger.
And he'll try to entice him with the changeup here, but it dips below the knees. It's 2-2.
And again, they try to take him down in the strike zone just to see if he'll go after that pitch below the knees. But with two strikes, he's been able to lay off that thing now twice in a row.
And he struck him out. So a good pitch there, and now they're going to need to string some hits together in this last at-bat if they want to get back in this thing. So it's no runs on a hit, no errors, and a man left. Nothing further in the Miami ninth. One last shot now for Philadelphia. They trail here 3-0. A.J. Ramos is on now to try to close things down here in the ninth.
A.J. Ramos.
Will Nieves will be tasked now with leading things off in their half of the ninth as they'll try to do something to prevent being shut out.
And whatever they've done for the first eight innings hasn't yielded a whole lot so far, so quite frankly, I'm not expecting too much.
And this one's nowhere close as that bounces to the plate for ball one. That's by him for strike one. Now a fastball is hit on the ground towards second. No problem here, one away.
Well, this is what you want out of your closer. Comes in firing darts, and it's a very quick out number one.
Dominic Brown will stand in, needing to do something here to get on base as they're down to their final two outs. Here's the first offering, and a fastball close but ultimately ruled a ball, 1-0.
You got to make sure if you come inside, you come way inside. You leave it out a bit, he's liable to hit that thing in the second deck.
And he looks at a changeup in there, 1-1. Bases are empty, one man out. Here's the 1-1. And that fastball's too much for him there, 1-2.
He's going to need to crank that swing up another notch if he's going to catch up to those.
Oh, he waits out the curveball there and shoots this one on into center field for a base hit.
Yeah, and plenty of hits here so far, but not a lot to show for it in the run column. Maybe this can help turn that around as they get a man on here with just one away.
Freddie Galvis will get another crack, 1-for-3 thus far. the first pitch. And he throws the fastball by him here, 0-1.
Well, he'll lean pretty heavily on that fastball. Why not? It's a big one.
That's on the inside corner to put him behind here, nothing in two.
Yeah, and it doesn't look like he's trying to get a ground ball here. He's coming right after him trying to get a punch out.
And this one's in the dirt. The throw pulls him off the bag. Cody Ashe will stand in as their last chance now. And here's a fastball called for strike one. Runners left in scoring position, one of the big keys to this ball game so far. Fastball, and he's got to duck away for dear life there. But one thing he's shown so far, he's not afraid to work inside.
Yeah, with that base open right now, he shouldn't have to be afraid. If you do hit him, big deal. Get the next guy.
And here's a swing and a miss, so the Phils are down to what could be their final strike now.
Well, nothing fancy. Three fastballs so far in this at-bat. He could go just about anywhere from here.
Runner in scoring position at second with two down. Runner staying tight to the bag at second. Here's the pitch. Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over.
Yeah, you know, this game kind of felt like it could have been played back in 1968. Very well played, very low scoring, very quick game, too. I'll tell you, I could go for a few more of these this year. That'd be okay by me.
One final check of the line score as you see the key players there in this shutout victory. Well, you always hope to get a good outing from your starting pitcher, but this man went above and beyond in this one. He's our Topps player of the game.
Yeah, he wound up turning things over to his bullpen in the ninth, but still, eight strong innings for him. He was hitting his spots all game long.
So that'll put a wrap on things here this evening. For my partners Eric Karros and Steve Lyons, I'm Matt Vaskirjian. This has been a presentation of MLB The Show. For more, follow us on Twitter, at MLB The Show. The Marlins win it 3-0. Good night from Philly.